There's something really special about churchyards and cemeteries and these sacred places. Whether you're of faith or not of faith, they just provide just little seas of tranquility, peaceful oases in what is an ever busier, noisier world. So the skills, the expertise, the local knowledge in a place like this is really important. That's really why they become better and better under the right kind of management. And I'm going to meet one of the people who really knows this place like the back of his hand and see some of the wildlife that he helps to support here. This is just a beautiful spot, Jim. How is it looked after?
Nowadays, it's mainly by Caring for God's Acre volunteers, the vast majority of it.
And what kind of things do they do?
Scything, mainly.
Scything? Yeah. And that, presumably, is just to make sure that the wildflowers have a chance in all of this grassland?
Yes.
And is it particularly good for wildlife, do you think?
It is, oh yes.
What's your favourite thing here, then?
What fascinates me is slow worms.
And this
is good slow worm habitat.
Well, they said, Jim, that I might see slow worms if I came here. They didn't tell me you were going to bring me one specially to show me.
Well, it's the best they could do. It's a juvenile. It's probably only about a year old.
Fantastic.
But a slow worm is a slow worm.
Yeah, and tell me about slow worms, since you're the expert.
Well, apparently they're quite long-lived, as reptiles go. I think they can live to about 30 years.
And do you find them everywhere here?
We've come across them all over the place. Even on the north side of the church, where it's quite cool, I sometimes see them. I don't think they're very adventurous. I think probably they find a habitat that works and stay there.
And that's part of the problem, of course, because I mean, they don't spread back across the countryside very easily.
No, they don't. And of course, nowadays, especially with farming being so heavily mechanised, entire populations could be destroyed without a thought.
Yeah.
By people who don't know they're there, to be honest.
It's quite a varied churchyard, isn't it? There's quite a lot of different habitats here.
Exactly. I mean, we're sitting adjacent to quite an overgrown area. There's lots of bramble. And these old graves, I'm looking at one now, there's an ant's nest there.
Oh, yeah.
They call them around here tumps.
What about the church itself? Presumably there are bats in there, aren't there?
There are a good population of natterous bats. And I was having a conversation this morning that we would like to put swift boxes up in the church. There's a population of swifts live in this area in the gatehouse.
So more to do. There's always more to do.
There's more to do, yeah.
Exciting. I mean, really exciting.
God's Acre is expanding from this churchyard, you know, and I think it's a good thing.